after we've had temperatures warming up. We had sunshine this afternoon, and the winds actually will start to melt the snow a little bit quicker too. But the winds have been howling. They've been nasty. It's one of those days you really have to hang on to the steering wheel as you're driving, because you can get one of these gusts and it can move the car around. Gusts right now upwards of 30, 40 miles per hour, but as we go through the evening, they should start to diminish a bit. Look at the strongest gusts we had all day. Mount Washington, 85 miles per hour. Of course, on top of a mountain, you're going to have winds a bit stronger there. Meredith, 46 miles per hour, the peak gusts there earlier today. Manchester, Portsmouth had gusts over 40 miles per hour, and on the Isle of Shoals, about 40 mile per hour was the wind gusts that they had there. The cold also with the wind makes it feel just brutal. Look at the wind chills. I was hoping we weren't going to have to talk about wind chills again, but here we are. We're talking single digits is what it feels like up in the North Country, while we have teens and low 20s when you get into central and southern New Hampshire. There were a couple of light snow flurries. You might have spotted them if you were out and about on Sunday afternoon, but those are fizzling away. And now we'll actually see the skies clearing during the overnight before this next storm system approaches. But here it is. Very similar to the one we just had roll through, so that is good in terms of our confidence in forecasting with this similar path that this one is going to take, and also similar strength. We'll likely have similar snow accumulation totals on Monday. The big difference, though, is the timing. This is going to come through during the day and during a weekday when a lot of us need to travel. So that'll be the bigger problem with this system. The snow will arrive in the early morning hours tomorrow. You see that we clear out during the evening here and through the early part of the overnight before clouds start to arrive, and the snow should start to arrive in most southern areas by about 7 a.m. So by the morning commute in a lot of communities there. And the snow continues to overspread at least up into central portions of the state by about 10 a.m. Now notice that cutoff line. It looks like probably the notches will be it for most locations. Anywhere north of the notches, you're lucky if you get a flake. But then once you get to the southern portion of the state, that's where we'll see the heavier amounts of snow, closer to the center of this low pressure system. We start to see the snow breaking apart, becoming more some scattered showers as we get into the afternoon and evening, but still could be a few slick spots for the evening commute home. That system pulls away and we're left with some nice weather on Tuesday. Here's how much snow we're expecting. 1 to 4 inches from basically the Lakes region and southward. This does include Concord, Manchester. And keep in mind that we could, in many of these locations, especially in the Lakes region, get only about an inch, possibly even less than that. So the further to the north you are, again, the less you're going to get out of this system. A dusting to 1 when you get closer to the notches and points to the north. The higher amounts closer to the 4-inch range will be in those far southern communities or higher elevations. So overnight tonight, it's